When Barry turned 65, we had the opportunity to organize, jointly with Professor Balakrishna and José María Sarabia, an international conference on distribution theory, order statistics, and inference in his honor in Santander, Spain, in June 2004. That conference was a success, and some selected papers that were presented at that conference were included in the volume Advances in Distribution Theory, Order Statistics and Inference, edited by Professor Balakrishna, Enrique Castillo, and José María Sarabia, and edited by Birkhauser in 2006. At this time, we celebrate Barry's 80th birthday, and together with José María Sarabia, my participation consists of this article, as a tribute to his academic and research career and to the joint work we have made. The first time I met Barry Arnold was at the Institute of Advanced Studies of NATO on Statistical Strains and Applications, dedicated to the memory of E.J. Gamble, held in Ribeiro, Portugal in 1983. The meeting took 2 weeks and was organized by José Tiago de Oliveira, and it was probably one of the most important meetings on this important topic. In fact, well-known scientists shared the knowledge and contributed to the development of this crucial field, not only in probability and statistics, but also in physics and engineering. I also met Janos Galambos for the first time there, and informed Janos about my desire of a sabbatical year at Temple University to write a book on strains and engineering. This stay started after the summer in 1985. During this stay, Janos and I wrote some common papers. The first one was born after a Janos invitation to myself to participate at a conference on weighted distribution at Penn State University. One Friday morning, Janos offered me this opportunity and mentioned that we could travel together by car from Philadelphia if I wanted to prepare a paper. Next Monday morning, we discussed a draft on our first joint paper and developed our paper with title Bivariate Distributions with Normal Conditionals, in which the more general bivariate model with normal conditionals was obtained. It is important to indicate that functional equations played a very important role in that paper and in almost all of the sequence of papers that followed. So, we cannot avoid mention the books of Janos Axel, who motivated later my books on functional equations. I mention this because functional equations have been very relevant in Barry's paper with José María Sarabia and me. The paper was presented at the meeting. By chance, Barry Arnold was there and liked the idea. Very soon, Barry wrote to Janos asking for permission to publish a paper with exponential conditionals based on the methodology proposed by us. I have to point out that Barry did not need our permission, but he was extremely polite and kind to follow this process. In fact, we were really honored by his letter because of the implied recognition to our work. Later, he published the paper in 1988 with David Strauss in JASA, and in 1991 another paper about bivariate distribution with conditionals in prescribed exponential families. In 1989, he published one important paper about compatibility in conditional distribution with IMPRES. In the meantime, Janos and I published the normal conditionals paper. Two examples of these families are shown in the figures, where they show a normal conditionals model with nonlinear regressions and a normal conditionals model with two modes. Later, in 2000, with Barry and José María, a normal conditionals model with 3 modes was published. In 1987, with Janos, I published one paper in which some conditional considerations allow us to solve a functional equation that generated a fatigue model for the SN curves. The idea is as follows. Suppose that several specimens are tested at different stress ranges, delta sigma, and that their fatigue lines are determined, n asterisk, that is, the SN curves shown in red in the figure. If we consider a generic point, delta sigma asterisk n asterisk, and the vertical and horizontal segments of the figure, it is obvious that any S curve crossing the horizontal segment necessarily has to cross the vertical segment, which implies that the shaded areas of the densities of n conditioned by delta sigma and delta sigma conditional by n asterisk to have to be identical, but those areas correspond to the corresponding conditional distribution function, so it must be what it is in the formula, where H and G are the conditional distributions. This is a compatibility condition. If we assume now that the function H and G belong to the same family of distributions, and that this is a location and scale family of distributions, the compatibility conditions can be written in the form indicated by this formula, which is a functional equation with four unknown functions whose solution is the one given here, where lambda and delta are location and scale parameters respectively, and A, B, and C are other parameters, and this is independent on the selected function H. Later, we also studied the conditional families specified by Weyl conditionals in Castillo and Galambos 1990, and later by gamma conditionals in Castillo and Sarabia 1990. Next, we present our main contribution with Barry to the field of conditional specification of statistical models. The fact that Barry, on one side, and José María and I, on the other, were working in similar papers having the conditional specification as the main topic, motivated an invitation from us to Barry in order to work on a joint book. The invitation was immediately accepted by Barry, and the book project started. After several stays of Barry at the University of Cantabria in Santander, we produced a monograph that was presented to Springer for his publication in the lecture note series on probability and statistics, and published as monograph number 73 in 1992. In a few years, the monograph edition was sold out, and then we decided to write a second book on the conditional specification of distributions. After some hard work, we produced a new book that was published by Springer in 1999 in his prestigious Springer Series in Statistics, Arnold et al. 1999. Immediately after publication of this book, we published an invited paper, Arnold et al. 2001, in the journal Statistical Science, with a summary of the material included in the book, and some new results and applications. First of all, we want to emphasize the importance of characterizing families of distributions. If we characterize a family of distributions in different ways, we have alternative definitions of these families. This implies a better and deeper knowledge of these classes of them. It also means that we are able to derive conclusions about these families from different points of view or starting points. The next theorem provides a relevant characterization of the bivariate normal distribution, see Castillo and Galambos, 1989. The density Fxy is a classical bivariate normal density if and only if all conditional distributions, both of x given y and of y given x, are normal, and any one of the following properties hold. Note that this means four different characterizations of the normal distribution. These results for the bidimensional case were extended to the conditional characterization of the multivariate normal family in terms of classical conditional distributions. Later, these results were extended to the case of classical conditional distribution. In Arnold et al. 2001, we move further from the problem of conditional specifications of distributions, dealing with the problem of determining whether or not a given set of constraints, including marginal and conditional probabilities and expectations of given functions, are compatible. We deal with the finite discrete case and converted it into a problem of linear equations in restricted domains. We introduce the concept of near compatibility and epsilon compatibility of conditional distributions. In Arnold et al. 2004, we studied the problem of whether or not a set of conditional probabilities are compatible and obtain all the possible solutions. It is interesting to point out that the classical bivariate number models are limited in the sense that they include only non-negative correlation, while the conditional models exhibit non-positive correlation. Three examples are given in the figure, where the positive and negative correlations become apparent. The following part refers to bivariate distributions characterized by one family of conditionals and conditional percentile or mode function. As illustrated above, the knowledge of all conditional distribution will typically serve to completely characterize a bivariate distribution if they are compatible. In addition, a partial knowledge can also be sufficient, as it is the case of the conditional distribution of x given y and the conditional mean of y given x. Thus, it is natural to ask whether or not a conditional percentile or mode function of y given x, together with knowledge of the conditional distribution of x given y, characterize the joint distribution. As a corollary, we obtain the following normal characterization theorem. The classical bivariate normal distribution is characterized as the unique absolutely continuous bivariate distribution with normal conditionals of x given y with linear regression and a constant conditional variance function together with a linear conditional mode function of y given x. With respect to the problem of distribution which generalizes Q conditional and mixtures of such a distribution, we obtain the following results. Some examples of these densities are shown in this. Next, we discuss some Bayesian applications. We have collaborated in some Bayesian methods in which we have explained the power of functional equations to obtain the more general model with priors and likelihoods in exponential family, and later the more general models with priors and posteriors, not necessarily in the same, but in well-known posterior family. Motivated by our research in conditional specification and by the paper by Gelman and Speed, we studied the problem of specification of distribution by combinations of marginal and conditional distributions. A particular and very interesting case of conditional specification is the case of Bayesian networks, which are defined by an aseptic graph of the set of nodes, variables, and a set of conditional distributions of each variable given its problem. The interesting thing is that the graph defines the dependency structure of the multivariate model, and the set of conditional distributions quantifies it. More important, this definition is always compatible, provided that the conditional distributions are well defined and that the graph is acyclic. The modeling of the fatigue life of longitudinal element was studied in Arnold et al. 1996. Other joint research with Barry, C. Arnold et al. 2006, was on the construction of families of multivariate distributions involving the Rosenblatt transformation. If we define the following, indicated in the formula, then the UIs are independent uniform 0,1 random variables. If we replace the uniformly distributed U's and dependent P's, which are assumed to have beta distributions, we have what is shown in the formula. The resulting joint density for underline X is then given by this equation, in which F of alpha I beta I denotes the density of a beta alpha I beta I random variable. We provided several specific models, a very simple estimation method for the parameters of this family of distributions, and applications with simulated and real data. Another contribution goes to the problem of probability distribution defined in terms of contours. The figure shows two examples of densities with elliptical contours, the left one with parallel axis ellipses and the right one with rotated axis. Our joint work with Barry Arnold covers several relevant fields of probability and statistics. Many of the most important contributions were made in the topic of conditional specification of distributions, characterization and estimation of new families of distributions. Other fields of our work include the construction of new families of multivariate distributions, multivariate order statistics, specification of fatigue models, and Bayesian estimation of parametric families using conditional specification priors. The research in all these topics continues to be an active field of work in current statistical science and should extend to other fields of applications, including applications in data science and machine learning. Now, I want to end my talk by saying that it has been a great pleasure, opportunity, and honor to work with Barry for many years, and we don't want to end without having a pleasant memory of Carol, who played an important role in Barry's life, and Sabrina, to which he devoted so much effort and attention.
Barry, we want to express here our gratitude and deep recognition in this, your 80th birthday, wishing you the best. Many thanks.